Hi, I'm Aisha Mushtaq. You are watching Educational Hub. Today we discuss about how to write objective in research paper.
First, we need to understand the term objectives. What is objectives? Research objectives specify how your study will answer it. They divide your research aim into several smaller parts, each of which represents a key section of your research project. As a result, almost all research objectives take the form of a numbered list, with each item usually receiving its own chapter in a dissertation or thesis. Each of your research objectives should be SMART, specific. Is there any ambiguity in the action you are going to undertake, or is it focused and well-defined? Measurable. How will you measure progress and determine when you have achieved the action? Achievable. Do you have the support, resources and facilities required to carry out the action? Relevant. Is the action essential to the achievement of your research aim? Time-bound. Can you realistically complete the action in the available time alongside your other research tasks? Checking research objective example against recommended approach. Research objective 1. Develop finite element models using explicit dynamics to mimic mallet blows during cup shell insertion, initially using simplified experimentally validated foam models to represent the acetabulum. Checking against recommended approach. Is it specific? Yes, it is clear what the student intends to do, produce a finite element model, why they intend to do it, mimic cup, shell blows, and their parameters have been well defined, using simplified experimentally validated foam models to represent the acetabulum. Is it measurable? Yes, it is clear that the research objective will be achieved once the finite element model is complete. Is it achievable? Yes, provided the student has access to a computer lab, modeling software and laboratory data. Is it relevant? Yes, mimicking impacts to a cup shell is fundamental to the overall aim of understanding how they deform when impacted upon. Is it time-bound? Yes, it is possible to create a limited scope finite element model in a relatively short time, especially if you already have experience in modeling. Does it start with a verb? Yes, it starts with develop, which makes the intent of the objective immediately clear. Is it a numbered list? Yes, it is the first research objective in a list of 8. How to write objective. The objectives are a very important part of a research proposal because they outline where the project is headed and what it will accomplish. Developing objectives can be a little tricky, so take some time to consider them. Then work on wording them carefully so your readers understand your goals. With clear objectives, your research proposal will be much stronger. Explain with steps. Step 1. Start each objective with an action verb. Objectives are about action, so use verbs when you list them. Think of strong action verbs to start each objective with. This makes your proposal look actionable and dynamic. For example, your objective list might read like this. 1. Compare the muscle development of children who play video games to children who don't. 2. Assess whether or not video games cause eye strain. 3. Determine if video games inhibit a child's socialization skills. Some proposals use the infinitive form of verbs, like, to measure, or, to determine. This is also fine, but refer to the proposal instructions to see if this is correct.
Step 2. State each objective clearly and concisely. Your objective should be one sentence at most. Use clear, simple, and actionable language so your readers can follow and understand your goals.
Step 3. Use specific language so readers know what your goals are. Objectives don't need to be packed with specific data, but they should have enough detail that readers know exactly what you're studying. Be as clear as you can so readers don't have any uncertainties about what you're working on. For example, determine if sunlight is harmful is too vague. Instead, state the objective as, determine if prolonged sun exposure increases subjects' risk of skin cancer. It's helpful to let someone else read your proposal and see if they understand the objectives. If they're confused, then you need to be more specific. Step 4. State your objectives as outcomes rather than a process. This is a small change, but it makes your proposal look more confident and actionable. Try to describe the objectives as definitive answers rather than questions. Confident language like this makes your proposal stronger. For example, don't say, measure the effect of radiation on living tissue. Instead, Say, determine what level of radiation is dangerous to living tissue. Remember, don't state the objectives like you've already done the experiments. They're still not answered. Step 5. Insert your objectives after your introduction and problem statement. In a normal research proposal format, you'll start with an introduction and statement of your problem or question. This lays out the structure and direction of the project. After these parts, then list your objectives. Each of these sections should have a clear section heading, so start the objectives section with objectives in large, bold text. This is a common format for research proposals, but not universal. Always follow the format that the instructions provide. Depending on how long your introduction has to be, you might also list the objectives there. This depends on whether or not you have room. Step 6. Note the objectives in the proposal abstract if you have one. Some research proposals have an abstract in the beginning. This is essentially a detailed summary of the proposal. If you're instructed to include an abstract, then briefly note the objectives in it. This way, readers can tell the direction of the project right from the start. At the very least, the abstract should list the general objective. This tells the readers what your study is working towards. Step 7. Introduce the section with your general objective first. Start off the objectives section with a few sentences about the project and its ultimate goal. In this introduction, state the general objective clearly, which is what you want the project to achieve. Introduce your objectives section with this general objective before getting more specific. In some research projects, the general objective is called a long-term goal instead. Adjust your language to the proposal requirements. Some proposals' directions may just want the specific objectives rather than a division between the general and specific ones. Don't divide them if the instructions tell you not to.
Step 8. List your specific objectives next. If you've already decided on your objectives, then this part is easy. Start a numbered list after your introduction and give each objective its own number. Remember that each objective should be one sentence max and start with action verbs. Keep the language clear and concise so readers can tell exactly what your goals are. Your introduction may be as follows. My long-term objective with this project is determining whether or not prolonged video game playing is harmful for children under 5. I will accomplish this aim by meeting the following objectives. 1. Compare the muscle development of children who play video games to children who don't. 2. Assess whether or not video games cause eye strain. 3. Determine if video games inhibit a child's socialization skills. The specific objectives are usually listed as bullet or numbered points.
Hopefully, you now have a good idea of how to create an effective set of aims and objectives for your research project, whether it be a thesis, dissertation, or research paper. While it may be tempting to dive directly into your research, spending time on getting your aims and objectives right will give your research clear direction. This won't only reduce the likelihood of problems arising later down the line, but will also lead to a more thorough and coherent research project. Best of luck for your research.
Thank you for watching. Like, share, and subscribe my channel for more informative videos about research.